This tutorial video provides a brief demonstration of how to establish communication with a PLC device. Take CODIS as an example. First, check the CODIS software and build a simple program with two variables. Download the program into the CODIS device to see the real-time data for the declared variables. The PLC environment is prepared. Next, use EasyBuilder Pro to establish communication with the PLC. Start a new project and select an HMI model. In System Parameter Settings, Device List, add the PLC device to communicate with. Click Device Type to select the PLC device supported by the HMI. For supported devices, refer to the Weintek PLC Connection Guide Manual. Select CODIS V3, Ethernet, and set the communication parameters. These parameters are crucial for achieving successful communication. Depending on the PLC, different communication interfaces and station numbers can also be set. Since CODIS is the example, import tags or click Get Tag Info to use the declared variables on the HMI. Use the XML tag file for importing. For information about how to obtain the tag file, refer to the PLC connection guide. After setting the parameters, let's start editing the EasyBuilder Pro project. Create two objects, a numeric object and a toggle switch. Assign the corresponding PLC variables to read, write tag addresses. Save the project and check the communication status through online simulation. If communication is not established, the device no response message will appear on the screen. Once communication is successful, the device no response message will disappear and the objects will display on the screen. Now, let's use the CODIS software to verify that communication is functioning normally. Change the status of the toggle switch and the value of the numeric object from the online simulation of the HMI. Alternatively, write variables through the PLC software and display their changes in the online simulation. At this point, communication with the PLC device is successfully established. The next step is to test with the physical HMI. Thanks for watching this video.